Time is brain.
Time is brain?
Time is brain.
That means that the longer that clot's in your brain, the less chance of survival, the less chance of your brain working properly. My name is Lori Hoopengarner, and I'm a stroke survivor.
So there's two types of strokes. There's hemorrhagic strokes and ischemic strokes. Ischemic strokes are responsible for approximately 87% of all the strokes, and hemorrhagic strokes comprise 13% of all strokes.
The hemorrhagic stroke, which is when an artery on the brain bursts and leaks blood out of the artery and causes a bleed inside the brain. The second type of stroke is a ischemic stroke, and is when the artery gets blocked by a blood clot, and there is no blood flow coming through that particular area of the brain.
I experienced a massive stroke. I remember I was eating a tomato, and all of a sudden, there was a red blur. I thought that was odd, and so I went to the kitchen table, and I sat down. My husband's talking to my dad. He looks over at me, he said, "Lori, what's the matter?" And I didn't answer him. My whole right side had become paralyzed, and I was unable to talk. My husband, being a fire captain, he said to me, "Lori, raise both your hands." Only my left hand went up. So he reached for the phone and immediately called 911. "My wife is not responding." I'll never forget hearing him say that. He sat me down in a chair, and I started to fall over. He knew I was having a stroke in his brain, but he just couldn't believe it. I was 41 years old.
So no one is immune from stroke. Stroke can strike at any age.
Making the call when somebody had a stroke is not as easy as other medical emergencies. The reason is stroke is most of the time painless. The patient who is suffering the stroke doesn't realize that he's having a stroke. And it's somebody else who noticed that there is something wrong with that person. Faster we get somebody into the emergency room, and the faster we treat the patient with ischemic stroke, the better the outcome is.
So the firemen and the ambulance arrived. They put me in the back of the ambulance, and they started taking me to Temecula Valley Hospital. The hospital had just opened about a year prior. We got to Temecula Valley Hospital, and they were ready for me. The ambulance had called ahead stroke, and they were ready for me. By that time, the left side of my body was flopping like a fish. They rolled me in, and they called a stroke. They administered TPA, which is supposed to dissolve the blood clot that had traveled to my brain. It didn't work. So some cameras came on, some TV screens came on in the emergency room, and three doctors came on the screens. And they agreed I was having a stroke, and they agreed I needed to be transferred down there because I needed a thrombectomy.
At this hospital, we now have advanced neurosciences, which means that we can do things in the brain that no other hospital in this region is able to provide. When I go out in the community and I share our services, people are amazed at what we can do here. We look like we're a small community hospital. We have very, very advanced care. A patient coming here in our new expansion will get to experience what we're in now, and this is a biplane room. It's exactly what it sounds like. In a traditional cath lab, for example, you've got a single plane of view where you can see one angle. In a biplane, you get to see two different views of the brain and see very detailed images of the brain. Our specially trained physicians can then take a look and see what's happening inside of there and quickly retrieve a clot or fix an aneurysm. And we've had amazing miracle patients that walk right back out of here.
Once the patient is ready to go, we prep the groin area. That's where we get access into the femoral artery. We go up with specialized catheters and wires. Stroke, we're usually what we call quote unquote sucking clot out. There's a clot in that, you know, one of the cerebral arteries. Once we have full opacity of contrast in that brain and we're done with the case, we're able to, you know, close the hole in the groin.
I came out of surgery an hour away from my home within 2.5 hours of the stroke occurring. Everything went like clockwork that day. I have been told that had I not had that thrombectomy, my brain would have swelled and I would have died.
I think being a neurointerventionist is one of the most gratifying jobs in the world, mainly because the patients that we get are usually extremely sick. Patients coming in with inability to speak or understand words, paralyzed on one side of the body, devastating neurological, in a devastating neurological state. And we're fortunate to be able to go in and find the clot, pull the clot out, and sometimes start seeing changes immediately on the table before the patient even gets back on the gurney and goes up to the ICU floor.
So historically, when a patient came to our ER and they received TPA, or it was ultimately determined they needed an interventional neuro procedure, time is brain in terms of this. So it's all about how quickly somebody gets from our emergency room to a facility who provided that care. And so it was a pretty complex process that involves a helicopter flying out to our helipad, wheeling into our emergency room, picking up the patient, and then flying them to down to San Diego for care. And so now we can receive those patients locally from neighboring hospitals as well as the patients in our ER.
Anytime we do advanced procedures at the hospital, we work in partnership with the region, and specifically the city of Temecula has a healthcare subcommittee where we look at what kind of services are important to this community. We look at how many patients are leaving the area for services that aren't provided here. And that's what really led us to advanced neurosciences, realizing that this service wasn't offered, and young people and of all ages were experiencing strokes and having to leave the area for the advanced care that they should be receiving right here. And when you're looking at someone's brain and the fact that every minute a brain cell is dying, the faster you can provide those services, the better the outcome for the individual. So it was an easy conversation with the city of Temecula that this was going to be an important service.
Going to a hospital that specializes in stroke is key, because there's multiple aspects of the stroke. There's a medication aspect, which is intravenous TPA, that hopefully will break off the clot, but sometimes it doesn't. And if it doesn't, then and the patient does have a large vessel occlusion, then the patient would benefit from mechanical thrombectomy.
This is significant technology. It's the first advance in stroke care in 20 years. The fact that we have it in our local community is fantastic, and it will save people's lives.
With advanced neurosciences and interventional neuro, it can't just be one person who's responsible for the entire program. It's truly a team approach.
Temecula Valley Hospital started the process that saved my life that day. Now, due to the fact that they do their own thrombectomies, they can finish that process.